Hello students, and welcome to lecture number 7 in this series. In this lecture, we'll discuss the limit state of collapse in detail again. So as I discussed in the previous lecture, the limit state of collapse can be considered in different ways, or we can say that the limit state of collapse deals with the failures due to flexure, compression, shear, torsion, and tension. So these are the possible reasons due to which the collapse or failure of any member will take place. So let us discuss this. Already in last lecture, we have seen some part of this. So again, consider there is a beam which is simply supported, and as present condition, there is no external load acting on this beam. The beam is not subjected to any forces. So then let us assume that the self weight is also not acting on this, because actually in normal conditions or natural conditions, if you rest a beam on two supports, then automatically the self weight of that beam is going to act, and that self weight of beam tries to bend this beam in a very minor amount. Okay, so that deflections or deformations will be very, very minor, which cannot be seen by the normal eyes also. But now let us consider one point load is acting on this beam. One external load is acting on this beam. So as the external load is going to act on the beam, as an effect of this, there may be possibilities of deformation of this beam. And mainly the deformation of the beam will take place like this. So the beam will get deflected like this due to the application of load. This load, it may be a point load acting at the center, sometimes it may be a point load acting at any disposition, or sometimes this load may be the uniformly distributed load. The type of load may be any, but ultimately, as the load is going to act in vertically downward direction as an effect of gravity, the deformation will be like this. So it is naturally that as this deformation is going to take place in this manner, so the fibers which are present at the top portion of this concrete, these all fibers are subjected to compressive stresses. All fibers are subjected to compressive stresses, and the fibers which are at the bottom, these fibers are subjected to tension. And as we know that, it means that just like this, the top fibers are subjected to compression, bottom fibers are subjected to tension. So as we know that concrete is very strong to sustain compressive stresses, but at the same time, the concrete is very weak to sustain the tensile stresses. So if we don't provide any reinforcement, what happens? And if we don't provide any reinforcement, and if we continue to apply the loads, then the cracks will start from this bottom like this. The cracks will propagate up to the top portion, and the failure of beam will take place, just like in this image. You can see this is a beam which is tested for the flexure, and if you continue to apply the point load, and as the point loads are increases, the cracks are started here. The initial crack might have started from this, so cracks are developed here, you can see clearly, and as the load is increasing, this crack becomes widened at the bottom and it propagates up to the top point, and when it reaches at this top fiber, immediately the collapse will take place. So that is called as a limit state of collapse in this case, in case of flexure for the simply supported beam. Now let us consider the example of cantilever beam. So as I told you, the cantilever beam, the conditions are reversing here in case of cantilever beam. If suppose this cantilever beam is subjected to a point load at the end, or in case of UDL also, if suppose that cantilever beam is subjected to UDL, what happens? That the deformation of this cantilever beam will be like this. So it deforms like this. So it means that now what happens here, the tension will be at top and the compression will be at bottom. This will be, there will be tension and there will be compression. So the exact reverse conditions are there as compared to simply supported beam. In simply supported beam, tension is at bottom and compression is at top. Here the tension is at top and compression is at bottom. So as I told you in previous part or just before some time, that we have to provide the reinforcement in the tension zone. That's why for the cantilever beams normally we are providing reinforcement in the top portion. That we are providing reinforcement in the top portion like this. Okay, so reinforcement is to be provided in the top portion for the cantilever to avoid limit state of collapse due to flexure. Now second is the due to compression, limit state of collapse due to compression. Compression means that if you apply a compressive nature of force on a member, then that member may be fail. Just like suppose if you consider a rectangular concrete block, and if you apply the compressive force on this, just like this, then this concrete may get disintegrated or it may be crushed at some particular point if the stress carrying capacity or the load carrying capacity of this particular block exceeds. So in the same way, what happens? Let us consider one example here. This is the failure of one column due to the compression only. So as you know, that column is a compression member because this column has to carry the compression forces like this, that whatever load coming from the structure, this load is coming acting in vertical downward direction. This column is supported over the support, so that's why the again the reaction will be in this upward direction. So this column is subjected to compressive forces. And what happens? That suppose if load exceeds beyond the limit or due to any other reason, suppose it may be deterioration or it may be environmental effect, due to the environmental effect some concrete may get deteriorated or that strength of concrete may get reduced. So as that concrete is not able to sustain those kind of compressive stresses, it bursts out, or the excessive crushing of that concrete will take place, which is happened here. You can see clearly that this concrete is crushed and spiraled out of that column, and that is the failure. This is called as a bursting of column. The main reason, one more reason is again that can be observed here, that you can see this picture and you can see this picture also. Here you can see that the links are provided which can be clearly visible. Here it is not clearly visible, but here you can clearly see that the links placed here are visible up to this point, and the last ring is present here. There might be one ring present here, but in this remaining portion the links are not provided, or it may be due to the lack of improper workmanship or lack of proper supervision. Such kind of things happen here, and as a result of this, what happened? That this portion becomes weak, and this portion is not confined, because normally this whatever links we are providing, these links are acting as a confinement reinforcement, and which is not happen here. And as a result of this, that whatever pressure is coming on this total concrete, that concrete is not able to sustain that pressure, and due to that it is crushed down, failed in that way. One more possible reason, the same kind of example you can see clearly here, that the concrete is failed due to the excessive compressive stresses. This is also example of one bridge column or bridge support. Now let us consider again one type of compression failure for the column, but it is the buckling. Buckling is different. In this case you can call it as a bulging of concrete, and this is a buckling. Buckling means it is a bending of column. just like in a transverse direction, this column may get bent like this. So here you can see that this is the particular steel columns as shown in this picture. If suppose the length of column is more than the least lateral dimensions or the lateral dimensions, in that case the column becomes slender. So here you can see that this buckling typically occurs in long slender columns. Just like if you take a 12 mm diameter bar and having a length of 1 meter, and if you try to push that bar from the both ends, what happens? That bar will get bent. So that is also called as a buckling. So similar, in the similar way, this buckling is happening here. So this is for the steel. You can see in case of concrete, here RCC element is there. So here you can clearly observe that the buckling of column is takes place, and mostly this column is in the parking area. And sometimes what happens that we are providing a larger height for the structure or some part of the building, and that column becomes slender, and that point is not considered by the engineer while designing that. Then there may be possibilities of failure like this. So you can see that the concrete in this portion is failed due to excessive cracking or excessive crushing. So this is the example of buckling, column buckling. The next type of failure is the failure due to shear. So as we know that shear, in case of simply supported beams, we have drawn the stress diagram, shear force diagram. So that shear force diagram for simply supported or the simply supported beam subjected to UDL, it is like this. Or simply supported beam subjected to point load, it may be like this. So we can see that the shear force is maximum at the supports, particularly for the subjected to UDL conditions. So in this portion, that from the center to the support, the shear goes on increasing. Shear goes on increasing is that in this direction, it is not constant in case of UDLs. So what happens that the cracks may get formed, as you can see, you can observe here. So here the crack is happen or propagated, started from this to the top portion. And this is the typical nature of shear cracks or shear failure. This is happens only because what happened, just as I told you, that whatever shear force diagram is also in the nature of shear force diagram is also like this. And if you draw the bending moment diagram for simply supported beam subjected to UDL, the bending moment diagram is also like this. So the maximum bending moment at mid span, zero at support. So this bending moment is also varying from mid span to support. Shear force is also varying from mid span to support. So due to these variations, what happened? There is a development of diagonal tension. Diagonal tension will take place, and as we know that the concrete is not able to carry the tensile stresses, and as a result of this, as the tension is going to develop here, the concrete will start breaking like this. So that is the reason why this kind of shear cracks are observed. Okay, so to avoid this, normally we are providing the bent up bars. You might have seen the reinforcement is provided like this. So this kind of bent up bars are provided only to carry the tensile stresses. That whatever tensile stresses are going to develop in this way, those are carried by this tension shear reinforcement. Okay. So this is the shear span, that this is the particular span from support to the remaining part of the beam. We have to consider as a shear span, and accordingly we have to provide a reinforcement that we'll discuss in detail in further lectures. This is the shear failure in case of slabs, punching shear. So again, as the slab is a very small, very thin section as compared to column and beams, the thickness of slab is very small as compared to its length and width. So there may be sometimes possibilities of punching shear. We may call in simple language as puncture. So such kind of punching shear is also possible, and such kind of failure may possible if we don't provide proper care. Okay. Then the next collapse is limit state of collapse due to torsion or nothing but twisting. If any member is subjected to twisting moments, then there may be collapse or failure, as you can see in this picture. So in this picture you can clearly observe that this crack is formed like this, and the concrete is damaged, or the concrete is crushed down over this section, and this is the mostly the most probable reason for this is the improper design, because you can see this is the pier of the bridge, and the whatever traffic is moving from this beam from this bridge, it may be from the both directions, or maybe mostly possibility is there that this direction of traffic will be in the one direction only and from this lane only. If suppose maximum traffic is going to this side, then it will produce a moment like this, because this maximum traffic is moving in this direction, so the force is acting in this direction, so it will tries to move this total portion like this. Okay, and it creates a twisting moment, it creates a torsion on this beam, and that's why the beam is subjected to cracks like this. So this is for the circular and this is the rectangular. You can see the cracks may form in this portion. So such kind of failures may occur. It is called as the limit state of collapse due to torsion. And the limit state of collapse due to tension is nothing but if you consider that the tension is going to develop in flexure, in torsion and in shear. Wherever tension develops, that concrete is not able to sustain that tension, and there may be failure of concrete part due to that tension. So to avoid that, normally we are providing the reinforcement in the form of torsional steel, or in the form of stirrups, or in the form of bent up bar. Stirrups and bent up bars are provided for the shear resistance. It is called as a shear reinforcement. And the torsional steel, it may be provided at the side faces, or sometimes we have to provide the additional stirrups. So let us stop here. Thank you.